Hi guys, this is Anash Sharma, and in this session we will discuss the slicer in Power BI. What is the slicer in Power BI? The slicer is a canvas visual filter. What does it mean? Slicer basically is a dynamic filters on a canvas. You can change or you can sort the data or you can select the required information through the slicer. The slicer is very similar to the filter, but there is a major difference between these, the slicer and the filter. The slicer works as a dynamic filter. It means when you interact with the reports, so that time you can change or filter the data. But the filters are the pre-configured. When you design the report, when you create the reports, so that time you can apply the filters. So those filters are hidden and the static. It means the end user cannot view your filters. So in this session, we will cover slicer for the text, how to format the text slicer, then date slicer, then how to format the date slicer, and finally number slicer. Before we start the practical on the slicer in Power BI, we have some data in Excel sheet. We check that data. In the first column, we have the segment, different type of segment, government, mid-market, then channel partner. On the second column, we have the list of the country, Canada, Germany, France. Third column, we have the product, pen, mouse, pencil. Then quantity sold, year of sales, sales date, unit price, gross sales, unit cost, net sales, profit. So these are the data. So my requirement is when I create the report or when I design the reports, so that time I want to filter some data. Suppose I want the total sales for the Canada country. I want the sales for the Canada and the pen product altogether. Then I want the total sales for the segment, country and pen altogether. So for this kind of filtering the data on the canvas, we can use the slicer. Let us do the practical of the slicer on the Power BI desktop. So already we have the data. So we discussed the data and this data is already uploaded. Now report section. So first of all, we draw the table. In table, then put the country and product, then quantity sold. So we have three columns. So for the better visibility, the font size already increased in the configuration. Now second, I take the pie chart. Then design that pie chart. Legend country, details, product in values, quantity sold. So both visual have the same data. Now slicer. In slicer, we take the country because we will filter the data on the basis of the country. Say, put the country in the slicer. So the moment you put the country field in the slicer, then the list is created in the slicer with the multiple option. Say Canada, France, Germany, Mexico, these are the country. Now, if you select the Canada, then you can see the data is changing in both visual. In pie chart, we have the data only for the Canada, and in table, we have the Canada data. If I select the France, then data we have only for the France country. Then Germany, so data is changing. For the multiple selection, control, then say France, Canada. Now, we have the data for the three countries. Canada, France, Germany. Actually, we are filtering the data. Now, suppose you do not want to the multiple selection, then you can disable it. How? Select the slicer, then format section. In general, selection control, and we have the single select option. By default, it's off. Make it on. So the moment you change the option, you can see the checkbox has been converted in the radio button for the single selection, say France. Now you cannot select the multiple option. Now when you click in this symbol, then we have the two options, list and drop down. I think it's not visible, list and drop down. So by default it's a list. If you select the drop down, then you can see it's a drop down is there. If you select on the drop down, then you have all the list of the country. Now suppose by default the format of the slicer is the vertical, and now you want this format of this slicer in the horizontal form. So select the slicer, go to the format section. In general, it's a there is an option orientation, and in the orientation we have the two options, the vertical and the horizontal. So vertical is a by default, and if you select the horizontal, the moment you select the horizontal, you can see the all the options, all the name of the countries have been changed in the boxes. So now you can see the slicer is in a horizontal form. Now we have the option Canada, France, Germany, Mexico and the United States of America. Now we check the hierarchy in the slicer. So right now we have the country only in the slicer. It means we can filter the data only for the country. But my requirement is, along with the country, I also need to filter the data product. Say Canada CPU, Canada hard disk, then the same way France CPU, France hard disk, France keyboard. How to do that one? Select the slicer, then so country field is already there. Now put the product below the country. The moment you place the product and in the slicer, you can see the downward arrow is appeared. It means you can expand this one. So click this one, so you can see the list of the product within that Canada country, and the same list in the France and same list for the Germany. Suppose in Canada I want to filter or I want to slice the data for the CPU, select CPU, hard disk, then France CPU. Say in Canada CPU multiple selection, control, hard disk, keyboard, pad. So it means the data is for the Canada and the four products, CPU, hard disk, keyboard, pad, and the same data is in the pie chart. Now we check the date slicer. So slicer and date type field, sales date in the field section, please. So once you place this date type field, then you can see the format or the layout of the slicers has been changed. It's a slider. The first option, the first box is the minimum date and second one is the maximum date. So these data are the between these two dates. You can change the minimum or maximum date. Say this is the minimum date. Data changed. Maximum date changed. Data changed. Now we have the different option for the date type. Select. Then the between, by default it's a range, minimum date and the maximum date. Then before, if you select, then first option means first date is the disable and this one is the enable. Before this date, also you can change this date. And next one is the after date. So now the second one, the second date is disable now. So after this date, again you can change this date. So data changed. Now then list. On the list we have list of the all the dates. So if you want to slice the data, if you want to filter the data for particular date, then you can select the date. Multiple selection, control, key. And finally, we have the drop down. So from the drop down, you can select the date. Now we check the number slicer. Take slicer. Then this time quantity sold. Numeric value, number type. Quantity sold filter. So by default, we have a slider. So 7 is the minimum value and 199 is the maximum value. It's a range. So it's a by default, and you can change the minimum and maximum value. Then we have some different options for the numbers. So first option is the list. So we have the list of the all the numeric value, quantity sold. So you can check the value from here. And then drop down. Already we have seen drop down. So you can select the value from the drop down. Next option is the between. That is a by default. Already we checked. And then less than or equal to. So this is the, this time we have only one value, 1999. So you can change this value. So we are filtering the value quantity sold less than equal to 550. Then next is the greater than or equal to. Now again same process, you can check. And to clear the selection or filter, then remove selection, this option. So guys, this was all about the slicer in Power BI. Thanks for watching the video.